here. I'm just going to take a quick look at your one.
Will celebrity treat us like a celebrity?
This is probably the most exciting time is boarding and cruise day. No matter how many cruise lines, cruise ships, cruises you go on, cruise day is the best. Here she is, a celebrity reflection. It's a little bit of older ship. Doing these quick 3-day cruises, which is awesome. A celebrity has started to do this. It's starting, I think earlier in May is when they start to do the 3 days, either April or May.
Now I bet she smells like you. Every day you're starting something brand new. On the road with your boy.
We are going. Where are we going? Make a left. Going to
All right. So you can't stay in your room, but you can drop your stuff off in your room and pick up your key. So that's awesome. That's the reason why we decided to bring our luggage on board and not have it with the porter. So that's really, really good. Oh, because the rest of it goes that way to $81.39.
So make sure before I pop the cork.
All right. Let's see. Reveal. So the rooms aren't ready, but we can at least drop our stuff off, so that's great. We're so used to just walking from our room straight on Toledo.
This feels weird.
It feels weird having a lanyard. Having to keep up with your card. So this is the Solarium, I think. So we're gonna walk through Lido to get to 15. So this seems like it's temperature controlled because it's very nice and warm in here. And it has a cover. So that's really cool. Nice cushioned seating. You already have your towels there.
I'm kind of liking this. Princess is great.
Celebrity is more modern money.
Yeah, it is modern.
Princess is more older money. Let's see what's up here. Good morning. So let's walk around here.
Yeah, I see it. Sunset Bar. All right.
We'll see if it's open. If not, we'll get food and go to Mustard. And
I can see my house again.
What are they called again?
Alcoves.
Yeah, these alcoves were like a couple hundred dollars. But with it being a couple hundred dollars or $100, like you didn't get anything special. Just the area. And it's not even facing the water. So we were like, we will hold off on that. So this is only a 3-day cruise.
Real grass.
I can tell it's real grass because it looks like our grass at home. That must be Bermuda grass right there. So let's see what Sunset Bar has to give us.
This is the canal we go down to go out to sea. We're on our boat. First time seeing it from this angle. It's awesome. What are you doing?
I am nothing. But I'm trying new drinks. We'll see how this goes. Beautiful ship though. It's a beautiful ship.
Yeah. I like the decor.
Ooh. Little sangria.
Nice.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah. Found your new favorite drink.
Oh. I've never had it in the orange. It was very light. Right. Now, I haven't had any much to eat, so we'll see. This one maybe one and done for the day.
First taste. It's really good. I don't even know what's in it.
What does it taste like?
Mango, pineapple, strawberry goodness.
Mmm. Well, maybe you can make one without pineapple. You can have the mango strawberry goodness.
True.
Lots of that. Yeah. All right, it is food time, and here is our view from the back of the ship. And we've been to the Lido Dining, and got a little salad from the salad bar. Got some grilled chicken, some grilled vegetables, some hummus. And I'm not quite sure what you call this, a papadopoulos? I'm not quite sure. But we're gonna try it and see, and some cheese. It had blue cheese in blocks, but not like crumble, but we'll crumble it ourselves. So beautiful view, beautiful day. So we're very thankful to God for that, for sure. We were in the midship elevators and it was crazy. So now we're coming, oh, they have an observation lounge. Let's take a look at this. Before we go to our master, and you guys go to your master early, don't be like us, but.
It's still early. It's 1:12:45. It's still early.
It's, what time?
12:45.
Okay. It's still early. Oh, this is like an observation.
Yeah. And you got a bar here. And I think this is where that club is too. Pretty sure.
This is what?
The club, I believe it's here.
Hmm. Very nice. All right, let's make our way to our muster station, but I'm sure there may be other stops along the way as we see things, as we are exploring this ship. So this is, an older ship in their
fleet.
But it's beautiful though. It's really well done. So let's head on out and see what's next. And this is the kind of music that you would not hear probably on Princess. Yeah.
Is that modern chic?
Yes, modern chic music. Yes. Like, I think I'm almost a little too uncool for that music. So we're at Reflection Theater for our muster. And just like that, we are mustered. We are all set to continue to explore. So this is, I call it shopping hall. All these nice shops here, which is nice and wide space. So that's really nice.
I keep saying,
oh, the casino. Interesting.
I like the decor. Like, the decor is really nice.
Yeah. The only thing is, the casino's open in the hallway, so I don't know how that's going to be with smoking, if that's going to kind of fill the hallway, but so far, things are beautiful. And now we're on the atrium, and I guess this would be considered the atrium bar. So I guess this is the atrium here, I'm assuming. So what's really cool about this atrium bar, if you can hear me, is that it's actually nice. It's cold. So it keeps your drink cold while you're having it. So that's actually really pretty cool. I guess it's considered the martini bar. So this is this is a real tree. I'm not sure how they water it, but so be it. And then Derek's in the egg. And we'll see if he comes out like a chicken.
Right. It's pretty cool.
Huh. I'm not sure how we all sit here.
I know, it's real tight.
Is this like a chair too?
It's a table.
Oh. All right, let's see how we both can get in together. So in order to sit in the egg, you have to really know the person you're with. Because it's a very tight space, but it's really cool. And I love the sunlight. That's so important.
That's what the old school ships had. Like, they had this, the light coming in through the atrium all the way down.
Yeah.
That's what I miss.
Yeah, because unfortunately there's some cruise lines where it's like a mall. You don't see any light at all. It's all artificial.
Yeah.
So it's really nice to see real light. But so far, so good. I'm actually pleasantly surprised at how nice the ship is.
The decor, I keep saying it, the decor is nice.
Yes, and the cruise has been fantastic. Yeah, so we are comparing premium cruise lines, and so this one, you call it LA, new LA money.
Right. And we lived in LA before.
Yes.
We understand that concept.
So this is new LA wealthy money. And then we say that the other premium cruise line that we travel a lot is
old retired money.
Yeah. So you
no
get
need to floss.
Yes, no need to floss. You get good service. Even like the Lido dining, the food was very healthy. Like
very.
Where the new young money people want to eat healthy, and the other cruise lines is like not. So very interesting comparatively, but so far so good. We're going to check out our room. Our room should be ready. It's around 1 o'clock. So we'll check and see if it's ready and kind of go from there and continue to explore. All right, we're going to start the room tour. We're in room 8139, which is a balcony room. And we will start on the inside here. We'll skip the bathroom for now because it's being occupied. But the room is actually pretty nice. We go in here, we have this full-length mirror here. And from here we have the closets. So you have your closet space. And the good thing about Celebrity is that they will allow you to put your things in the closet even before your room is clean. And then your room isn't clean till after 1 p.m. And they also have robes, which is my favorite. But you have a shower, so it's perfect. And then we go along here, this wonderful picture, and we have the bed here. Let's see, is the bed? Oh, it's a little firm. It's a little firm, I must say. So this should be interesting. And then we have a sofa. So it's good to know that all the balconies, assume, has a sofa. And then we have your drawers here. Here's your TV. Here's your safe. So it's important to know your safe is actually here, where the TV is. And then here is the refrigerator, but found out the refrigerator is already stocked with stuff. So we tried to put the water in there.
A few more final safety points that we must cover before we set sail. Immediately following this
so we'll be back. The captain's on. We'll be right back. All right, so let's continue the video after the safety briefing. So this is the bathroom. This bathroom is actually pretty nice. I must say it's very spacious for a cruise ship bathroom. Everything, your hair dryer is over here. They do have the bar soap for the hand, which is not my favorite, but you have your hand soap. We do have some lotion. Our toilet paper was found here, so I guess this is where we'll keep it, I suppose. And then your trash is kind of hidden in here. And then here's just some extra items. And then we have the glass shower. I don't think that we've had a glass shower on a cruise ship yet. So I'm very excited about having this. And it's pretty big. It's pretty spacious in here, which is great. It's a really nice bathroom. I'm quite impressed. All right, so we'll move on to the balcony. So we have stored our luggage in the closet, but we've taken it out and we've actually used our sofa as our kind of a luggage holder here. And we have another wonderful mirror here. You can see all the stuff. And then I always get this wrong. Okay. Oh, Garrett pre-opened it for me, which is great. And so we have here, and it's a hot day in Florida, your balcony, and you have actually a real nice size table here. So very good. There's your balcony. The floor is a little hot, but here we go. Awesome. Looks like the island princess down there is on the move. Woo! Hot floor, hot floor.
But that would be it. Pretty nice room.
Celebrity Cruises, young, working money.
It's cool.
It's cool.
They have something to lose.
I know.
They won't be acting crazy. They're going out of the cruise line.
Young party money. Which is cool. It's a different vibe.
I want you to say young party money. I'll say professional money.
Yeah, professional, young, working money.
Yeah.
Which is cool. Different vibe. Great.
So I'll tell you what, if you compare this to Carnival, you would have a bunch of ratchetness and fights and stuff that doesn't look like this. Completely different.
I know.
Different vibe.
The Carnival crew has always been fantastic, but this is different. They want to enjoy themselves, but they want to respect each other as well.
They understand what they paid for.
Yeah. Understand what they paid for and understand what they have to lose.
Right.
Yeah.
Great. But at the end of the day,
would I choose celebrity or princess? It'd be princess. Like, celebrity's a good 3-day weekend. Great. Love it. I have no complaints. Princess long haul for like 10, 15, 20 days, princess all day long. This is what it is.
And we are officially on vacation.
Yes.
We're going down the channel now to the ocean. So Port Everglades channel. Celebrity Reflection is actually cruising out of Port Everglades in Fort Lauderdale, which is a little bit easier cruise port to navigate versus Miami, because Miami always have so many ships in port. So this one's a little bit easier to navigate. So we've made it into the shade. So this is great. So we can see a bit more. You'll see there's the bridge. So we're pretty close, far up forward on the ship. That's why there's such a long walk to our room. Have made it to almost through day one of the Celebrity Reflection 3-day cruise. It's actually really good. It reminds me, so it's cross between Royal Caribbean and Carnival, but at a higher level. Lots of great music, lots of vibrant people, the food is great, the crew was fantastic. So it's been actually a really good first day. Good day. I think he said yes. Mm-hmm. And I was like, has it been a good day? Yeah.
Yes.
Yes, I think he said it's been a good day. So we are headed to Bimini, and we are going to do the Bimini Beach Club, which we've never done before. And so Bimini's a very small island, not a whole lot to do. So last time we were there, we actually did the golf cart around, which was great. But this time we're doing the beach club. It actually was really hot today in Fort Lauderdale. Our server says it's supposed to be even hotter tomorrow. So getting in the water is going to be paramount. So we'll let you know. We're going to call it quits early today, and then we'll see you tomorrow. We are in Bimini. Bimini. We're down the street from the house, technically. But, you know, we're pretend like we're really far. beautiful though. The beautiful weather and the waters of Bimini. We went to breakfast. It was a little chaotic for breakfast. Lido dining was super full.
It's not Princess, I tell you that.
Yeah, it's...
They don't serve you like Princess. They don't come to your table. There's lines everywhere. It's kind of like a elevated Royal Caribbean.
Yeah, I would agree with that because at least with other cruise lines, like they come to you for drinks. We had to go like seek out drinks and go to the bar to get water. And just...
I want to be catered to.
Next cruise. We're going in, this is our first time. Virgin actually uses this one as well. Okay, so Derek is getting the free welcome drink. And I'm gonna move on and we're gonna go get some seats at the beach and see. They have a really great big pool. I don't know if it's heated or not, but we want to kind of set the ocean and see that we'll see kind of what the water is like. Let's see. Let's go. And this excursion that we paid for comes with lunch. The lunch didn't seem too super impressive, so we'll kind of see what the lunch is when we get to it. But let's see if we can find a chair up front.
Welcome.
Thank you. Okay. All right, let's see. Now the chairs look very interesting. We'll use that terminology. But let's see where we can go. So hope that we don't fall through any of the chairs. Let's see what we can find up front. And he made maybe a little bit on his pants, but he made it through. So there are two sides to this resort. This is apparently 360, and she says related to the restaurant 360, which I'm not sure if that's where we're going to have our lunch. But we were told that it was completely fine to stay up, be over here, and the chairs are much better than the ones that you have over there. And then the chairs are much better at the pool than they are over there. So we're gonna try it out. Hopefully no one asks us to leave. but we're gonna try it out and see. And go from there.
Chilly.
It's cool.
Very.
Beautiful beach of Bimini Resort. Water! It's a little chilly. For us. For others, it's probably really nice. But it's very clear. Very clear, beautiful blue. Just like in the Bahamas. Beautiful blue. In the top.
Waiting for it to hit midpoint. That's when I'll scream.
We'll just have to go in. Just, I mean, the air temperature is hot, so this would be great and refreshing once we are brave enough to get the rest of the body in.
As far as I'm going.
Yeah, but just sit down. Just go down.
I got a pool that I maintain at like 89 degrees.
So I think probably this temperature is probably in the 70. Water temperature. No, probably in the 80s. The mid 80s, the water temp.
But I think if these go in, you'll feel much better.
We have two beach days.
So you're just trying to...
I'm just chilling on this one. I want to be further south in the Bahamas to get a little warmer water. That's my strategy.
Yeah, I don't know, because it's not too far. Coca K is not, I don't think it's too far from Bimini. Just my thoughts.
I can pretend it is.
I'm going to try. Go first. I had to get out because I've been turning very multiple shades of dark from the water. Very nice though. Yeah. Cools us down for a hot day.
Yeah. Now it's time to relax and just watch the water.
Yeah. Hopefully take a little, you call it sea nap when you're by the ocean and the waves are just so relaxing, it just puts you to sleep. Mm-hmm. That's what we're going to do. We spent a wonderful day in the water. The good thing is that there's one ship at a time that comes here, so it's not super crowded, multiple ships. So that's great. And then we're gonna see what they have for lunch to see if something we want, or will we go back on the ship and eat? Because we got lunch included. We did the Bimini World Bahamas Beach Club, and how was that?
It was fun, relaxing, drinks were good, food was, didn't have any because it was like so small amounts, we're like, we have a ton of food on the ship, so.
Yes, they actually had one rib, so they had ribs, and they gave you one. Not a rib platter, but one rib. So we're like, well, we might as well just go back to the ship and we're going to eat and rest and actually explore the ship even some more since we only have a short period of time. On the reflection, we're going to kind of explore a little bit more and see how that goes.
Why is yours?
Waist turn,
just doing a little ship tour. We're back on board. We're coming down to the, we're on deck 5. We're looking for the Tuscan Grill because we'll be there tonight. So this is a bar back here in the Ensemble Lounge. So Michael's Club, it's a members only. I'm not quite sure what Michael's Club is.
Who are members?
I know. Not sure what it is or what members are in there. And there's lots of dead space, I would say, back here. filled with art, which is good, but I'm not quite sure what kind of restaurant this is. This may be the specialty restaurant where they have like your plate comes to life. I think that's what this is.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And then we have the Tuscan Grill. And this is their Italian steakhouse.
On the back of the ship, you see those square windows.
Ah, very pretty on the inside. Yeah. They're very open. The windows are, you can see. So very excited to be here. I think we made a good choice.
Oh, you got gorgonzola. Oh my
got dry age too. It's more money.
Do you see a lot of food?
A lot of food. Can't wait.
A great menu and a great view. We're just at the appetizer. We just made it to the appetizer.
Oh, looks good.
And this is why we have to exercise. When you go overboard. It is definitely lots of chairs. I can smell the sweetness of, what do you call those? When I went to get, huh?
Churro.
Some type of churro, something, sweet something.
Right on here?
It's up to you. Yeah, mm-hmm. You're supposed to. The beauty of getting here early is you get prime spots. In the rain, in the Caribbean rain. Let's go further. Let's go around. So, do we have a happier Derek now that you found a place to sit?
Am I what?
Happier.
Perfect.
A little bit. That's his happy smile. So I'm gonna actually put some sunblock on, but let's take a look. So it's more like a little cove, I would say, versus we're in the ocean, so the water's nice and calm, which is good. We're getting a little shower. Hopefully that it turns fast, it goes fast.
That's high school. That is like high school. It's like we're further south, but yet this is colder. Oh, I understand why. The wood is deeper. It's blue right over there, so it's a lot more colder. Whereas when we're in Germany,
I don't think it's as deep. Cause look at they're sitting
there. I think they just. Oh. So you got all that cold water coming in, whereas in Bimini you got the large shelf. It's really, it's not that deep. You got the nice clear, emerald green, bluish water. So that's why it's cold. I understand it now.
Does that make it better?
No.
Doesn't make it any better.
Feels like home.
I don't think it's as cold. Home.
I don't know.
So we'll do a spin. So not super crowded, as you can see.
Two ships here, Allure and Celebrity Reflection. Allure to Seas or Celebrity Reflection.
Yes. Which we didn't realize that it was going to be a Oasis class ship. So this is another reason why we're happy we did the adult only.
Only kids.
Yeah.
I like peace and quiet. Yes. Well, adult quiet.
Yes. All right, we have lunch at Coco Cay. We have funnel cake, french fries. We have mozzarella sticks and chicken sandwich. So Derek's gonna try the chicken sandwich and let me know.
It's like a school chicken sandwich.
Well, they have other stuff if you want dressing on your sandwich.
Not bad.
Not bad. Mm-hmm. Is it Chick-fil-A?
Mm-hmm.
No. But not bad for beach food. Derek's eating the funnel cake.
Maybe.
It's amazing. Ooh.
It's amazing. It's really good.
So the food so far is good. The chicken sandwich is actually really good. The fries may be a little undercooked, but they're good. And the mozzarella sticks are good. So this is all the things I've heard people talk about. So I'm very excited that we were able to try it. And so far so good.
Yeah.
It's just a very hot day, which makes sitting in the chairs that are 90% in the sun very miserable in a sense. So we're going to try another location on the island to see if that we can kind of hang out at one of the bars under kind of an awning.
Hopefully a fan.
And to kind of cool us off and continue to enjoy the island. So third journey?
Something like that.
It is
hot.
Very hot.
Like, I typically don't do icy drinks, and I switch 100% to icy, just to cool off.
Yes.
Daggery. So.
It is super hot. But we found this little bar place on the island called On the Rocks, and it overlooks the ocean, and the breeze is amazing. So, just FYI, if it gets too hot on the island, kind of retreat here. And they have live music. Oh, I think they're testing right now, but how'd you end up with two? You only had one.
Making sure you didn't knock it down.
Oh, right. Very good. Great breeze. I know. They said it was a 5-minute walk, but I'm like, who was actually timing the 5 minutes? Somebody, this is no way that's a 5-minute walk. It's too hot to be unchilled. Yeah, so we came out early to get back early because we know how Caribbean heat is, and when it gets lunchtime, it's too hot. And so we're done, which is great. So we're heading back to the ship. So we're here with the Allure of the Seas, and we're heading back. And then right there's another island for actual Norwegian. So Norwegian's private island is just literally right next.
is a perfectly hot day in CocoCay.
Way too hot.
So we're in the theater.
Our
going to be watching El Siam, I think that's what it's called. So we'll see. But we got here about 30 minutes early and it was fairly empty.
Yeah, not like Princess, you just have a few people.
Yeah. Yeah, so which is good. Out on the verge, out on the verge of the rest of our lives. This could be the end of everything. So why don't we go somewhere only? We have made it to the last day of our 3-day cruise here on Celebrity Reflection. And giving us our last minute thoughts. So overall, I think the cruise has been great. On a scale of 0 to 10, I think it's a solid 8. The staff, the crew has been great. Extremely friendly, extremely helpful. The food has been good. I mean, it's, you know, we've had some cruise lines that the food was better on. We had some cruise lines, the food was worse. So this is actually a pretty solid 8 as well, I think, on the food.
Yeah, definitely.
I meant a few words. we ended up seeing one of the shows tonight, and the show was actually pretty good. They didn't have a lot of, so there's no live band with the show, and they didn't have a lot of techno stuff either. But it was overall good. Yesterday we saw one of the house bands play, and that house band was actually pretty good as well. So the entertainment that we've gone to has been pretty good.
Yeah. And I'd say overall, Celebrity is a good cruise line. Would I do it again? Yes. I'd do a 3-day and enjoy myself. But I think Princess is just another level above that. Just because, to me, this feels like Royal Caribbean elevated, but a lot of Royal Caribbean. So
yeah, not like a completely different experience. It feels like the Royal Caribbean experience, just at on a nicer ship.
Yeah. Oh, the decor is beautiful. Like the ship is beautiful. I like the layout. There's a lot of things I like about the ship itself. The service was great, but it's just the finer details, that's all.
Yeah.
You know, like the Lido, you know, you're used to talking with the crew more, you know, they bring you drinks on Princess, like regular drinks, not even alcohol, just like
juice.
Yeah, they offer you. It's just it just feels more elevated on like a Princess or a Holland America versus
yeah, you know. So I think for us, for it to be considered a
premium
cruise, I probably wouldn't say that. because it's the attention to detail, I think, that Celebrity is missing. But is it a great cruise? Yes.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, we've had fantastic time.
We'll do it again. Yeah.
Yes. But is it a premium cruise line to getting that premium service? No.
Yeah. And I can understand, like, people rave about Celebrity, and it's a great cruise line, especially if you don't know anything more. You know, but we've experienced this a little bit more attention to detail on other cruise lines, and that's what's missing on this one. So it's not bad. It's just, you know, there's certain things that we're expecting. When you call yourself a premium or luxury cruise line, or just sub-luxury, whatever you want to call it.
So, sub-luxury. I think that's a good description.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's like not regular, but it's not luxury. It's like a sub-luxury.
Yeah. So
actually, that new category.
And I say we're not knocking Celebrity. Yeah. Celebrity's been great. We'll do it again.
Yeah.
It's just, you know, we were just, people hyped it up, and I'm like, okay, I mean, there's just something's missing that we're used to experiencing. Yeah. It just, as a first person on any, like a Princess or Holland America, you don't need to have any class or anything like that.
higher tiers and stuff, just as a regular tier, you know, that's missing on this. So
yeah, but it was, I mean, again, we would definitely do a 3-day cruise on this cruise line without hesitation, because we did have a great time. It's we had great ports, and we hope that you get a chance to come and enjoy the Celebrity Reflection. It's an older ship, but it's a beautiful ship. So,
and that's what we like to do. We like to pick the oldest ship of the line, and we expect good quality across the line, no matter what, if it's a new ship or old ship. So we like to pick the old ship to get the experience of the brand, and the brand's great. You know, the brand is really good.
Yeah, so it is. Do it again. Yeah. So enjoy, and then we'll see you on our next cruise.
Yeah.
Bye. And just like that, we are off.
Yeah, it's very easy.
Very easy. Very easy disembarkation. We'll see you in the next video.